Hey guys, welcome back to Actraiser 2. Let's head back into the palace and start whooping some ass. Let's just go in immediately. We already read this last episode. The king is still possessed, he's asleep, blah blah blah. Let's go into his mind and just wreck stuff. Man, I hope we actually go into his mind, that'd be pretty neat. However, I kinda doubt it. Anyway, let's go ahead and see what the palace looks like without all this ice BS everywhere, you know what I'm saying? Alright, here we go. I'm a little bit antsy, Ooh, yeah, it looks similar already. A little bit excited here. Okay, so we got little bouncy ghouls coming at us with 3 hits. You look at that small-ass enemy. I immediately was like, oh, this guy only has 1 hit point. Oh, and we got homing balls, too. Get off! What? I can't... All right. Okay, we just need to get inside. How about that? Because literally everything is grinding into me, and I can't really respond to it. I should have methodically been taking these guys out. Oh my god, look at that thing. But last time I was here, this little entrance segment, it literally took maybe 5 seconds, and for some reason it extended here, so that kind of sucked. But we made it! Oh my god. This is actually beautiful. What are we doing here? I guess we're climbing upwards? It doesn't look like I can stand on that rock, so why don't we head over to the right? Maybe? There doesn't appear to be any platforms over there either, I guess. No, I can't stand on that. Okay. What do you want from me, game? Am I supposed to make a blind jump off somewhere? I suppose that's what the game wants me to do. So, blind jump off to the side? Yeah. What the hell is that? Is it a door? This is a mini boss, I guess? I am so utterly confused with the design of this level. Alright, well, I'm most definitely gonna die here, mainly because I was just a lazy asshole at that very intro, you know, the very first screen that we were on. And I told myself before I started the video, I was like, Alan, we're gonna be very methodical, we're gonna beat this level our first try, we're not gonna lose any lives. Ha! What a fool. Such a fool. Oh, well, at least it respawns me back here. I don't know if maybe I should use a little bit of magic. This guy actually seems really easy. The only part that's gonna be really hard is taking care of all of his little sperms is shooting out, but they only do you know, half a tick of health, so why don't I just let him be an asshole and take him down like this? I don't know, I mean, it's definitely the lazy way to do it, but it's kind of the way how I wanted to do it. And there's that weird oddly placed door. That thing looks so weird in this, you know, beautiful environment that we're in, and then there's just like a blue door. Hey, how's it going? Looks really bad. Oh my god. Maybe we are going into this guy's head. This is... what? Oh, I'm actually steering this platform around. Oh man, I'm gonna get nauseous. This is actually... oh my god, this is freaking me out. Whoa. So the screen is rotating around up... or is it? It's actually kind of moving on its own, I think. Oh, I shouldn't have jumped. That just confused the hell out of me. What is happening here? I can't tell if I'm steering the platform now or... yeah, I still am. Just the way it's, oh, it's convulsing and spinning is really getting to me somehow. But I like the design a lot. Oh god, it's about to start turning again. I need to get in a safe spot. Okay, this looks like a reasonable place. Kind of like the center of the screen seems to be a good idea. But what the hell? Why am I being pulled to the left? Or am I? I'm moving to the right, but the screen was pushing me to the left. This is one of the coolest and most confusing segments I've been in a video game in a really long time. I'm really not sure as to how to control anything, nor as to what exactly my goal is. Definitely need to get out of this dead end, though. Okay, here we go. And I'm so looking forward to getting... what? Move! What are you doing? And when I jump, the platform flies over to the left. Like, I'm moving to the left and it's moving me down. Okay, so I go up. Oh, I get it. Okay. So the controls don't actually change. It's just my perspective that changes. It's similar to getting a mushroom on your head in Earthbound. Okay, so this is right. This is down. Okay, so I'll just move my controller. You know, just rotate the controller exactly the same that I do in Earthbound. To, you know, accommodate myself for the change in controls. Okay, so down. I gotta reorient it. Right is up now, so left is... well, actually, still... oh, wait, no, the controller is back to normal? God, this commentary sucks. Whenever you're commentating on a game and you're dealing with hellish controls, The commentary always blows ass because trying to describe the controls, you just sound like a complete fucking moron. Well, we found a red door, surprisingly, and yeah, we are going to have another mini-boss. I kind of expected that. This moon, I'm assuming that's the Earth. That's really pretty. Alright, so where is the mini-boss here? Or is this going to be the boss? Actually, now I'm thinking about it, because we did already fight. Ooh, that's a good point. What the fuck just happened? Oh, my gentle good guy. Oh, he's so scary. Oh, wow. That hurt a lot. Well, we're at the last life here. Let's go ahead and start throwing balls. Doing good damage. That thing explodes like a mother bitch, so let's just be careful here. He warped out of existence, it sounded like. Last time I heard that... Oh, fuck. I was gonna say, last time I heard that noise, I actually got warped to a different level segment. Ah, yeah, as I did here. Now, where do I want to go? I'm so confused. This level design here is so surreal. I literally don't know how to handle it. It's actually a nice change of pace. I like it. I'm just going to wait here until he shifts me to another dimension. Okay, here we go. And then we're going to be back close to this platform where I can throw more balls into him. Then I'm just going to take cover over here, dodging that massive explosion. This boss actually seems really easy. But I don't want to count my chickens yet. He's going to warp and warp back, which is going to teleport me to another area. I think I got this boss down. Now, if I can get back to that main platform, I can lob some more balls into him and probably just finish him off with a little sword strike. There we go. God damn, you are a freaky mamma jamma. He had like a heart inside of him and his face was all... What? Huh? No, I'm not Oh no, it's the king. Are you okay, king? Oh god, that scared me. I thought we were gonna have another segment there. What an incredibly amazing level. And it's one I actually beat in 7 minutes. Oh man, you know what that means, viewers? You're getting another 2-level episode. Oh yay, joy to the world. Joy to the world. Oh good god. Really not a good idea, but why, well, you know, what the hell. The palace has been clear. We're finally done with this area. We're probably gonna head further south. Alright, the king was grotesque and mysterious. The mind of one who gives himself to deception seems to be very dark. Wow, okay. So, okay, the king is finally awakened. He's begun to teach the people. Ah, great, he's teaching the people the power of deception. Wonderful. The king has prevailed. When deception surrounds you, always will you choose the wrong path. Take note, viewers. This game is teaching all sorts of life lessons. I hope you're paying attention. If you, you know, can actually have the patience to learn said life lessons going through these hellish levels, good god. I can hear people screaming to the southeast of here, let us go and investigate. If you can hear people screaming from that fucking far away, oh man, then I am very nervous about what we're about to encounter here in Leon. I'm the great Leon! Star Fox, anyone? This was not a rich country, but the people were honest and full of gratitude. So another king... is causing a bunch of ire around here, raising the taxes, so Robin Hood's gonna come out of nowhere. They were sent to underground prison in Gratis. Please go east to the underground prison and release the people. This giant hole in the ground? Oh, good god. This is Gratis. People from Leon were sent here to be imprisoned. Oh, god. It's like the prison in the latest Batman movie. Oh, don't worry, I'm not gonna spoil anything, but... Oh, it's like this giant hole in the ground. This is... Oh, it's gonna be interesting, let's just put it that way. So let's dive on in. Maybe I can beat this level with the same amount of ease that I beat that palace level, hopefully. That palace level, it started off really rough, me just kind of walking into all of the enemies, but welcome, master, to your doom! Welcome to die! And you have these statues, like, what are they doing? Alright, well, oh good god. It's gonna be one of these levels, isn't it? Alright, well, let's get moving here. We'll just move a little bit carefully. Probably don't want to go downward. I'm guessing... Oh, I remember you little poking spear bastard. Yeah. Probably going to be, like, a lot of spikes around here and stuff, judging from these pits. I'm just kind of totally guessing here. Let's casually float down. I'd like to get over to that item, so... Oh, whoa, Slimer. I'll make that my first goal. Oh, good, and we have the Medusa heads that shoot at you. That is just absolutely wonderful. But combined with the ceiling spikes, man... This level is just rehashing all of my favorite tropes in this game, isn't it? Well, let's head upwards, and we're going to go grab that item. Oh, get out of my face, buddy. And maybe get a little bit of magic. I don't necessarily. Oh, fuck my ass! 3 MP! Oh, man. I'm liking my chances here on this level so far. I know it just started, but. Can I go up? Is that. No, okay, I was gonna say, is that actually a thing? What's gonna go on here? I guess we need to head down, so I'm just gonna float. Oh, man, this makes me really nervous. It's gonna be a pit of spikes, isn't it? Pit of spikes, okay. Harrowing jump. Oh, man, I hate these. Oh, jump, master. Jump. Okay. Now, let's wait here, because I know this fucker's gonna come back and shoot at me. No, he came back from the side that he originally came in from. All right. Can't go through. Ow, what the hell? That shit pisses me off. I hate it when enemies just magically spawn on top of you. It's kind of a little frustrating. I don't know. All right, well, I'm guessing we're going the right way. Do I want to go down? Fuck off with this. I don't think I want to go down, so let's carefully make our way up here, not jumping into any spikes. However, I think I'm looping. Am I looping back around to where I was before? I don't know, but I'm getting a lot of rehashed enemy sprites, which. Oh, Jesus. This isn't the way to go, is it? Unless I go up, but I don't think I can make that jump. Can I? No, I cannot. So, down is our only option. Yeah, I kind of like having the rehashed enemy sprites just for the sole reason that I know how to handle all of these fuckers. Which is really nice. It's nice knowing how the enemy AI works in a game where it's so GD brutal, you know? So I'm gonna head over here. And it's a little bit, you know, it's more illuminated over here. There are a lot of enemies, so I'm thinking, man, I'm thinking this is the right way. The imagery in this game, namely this level, is really dark. There are a lot of strung up corpses, skeletons. Like, this is, it's pretty fucking dark for a Super Nintendo game, honestly. We get more MP and more HP. I'll definitely take all the MP drops I can get because I'm probably gonna die at some point. Though, you know, then again, God, this fucking guy with the lasers. It's probably the worst thing ever. But yeah, I'm probably gonna die, and it would be nice to have that MP carried over to my next life, and I knew there were gonna be spikes down there. I can't hit this guy, so unfortunately, well, maybe I can jump on that cage. I'm not gonna risk it, just gonna waste a little bit of magic. I can't jump on the cage, so I don't really know how I was supposed to take that guy down. Look at that, the laser guy killed me. That's really shitty design, I'm sorry. Alright, here I am. I literally followed the exact same path I took last time. Minus getting that single MP that is directly above me. I got the 3 MP, but I did not get the single. Okay, so we're gonna watch out for these fucking guys that are just gonna magically spawn. They didn't appear this time and laser me in the back. That's so frustrating. And was I, like, right next to a checkpoint? Oh my god, I was. Well, what can you do? All you can do is just, you know, get better for next time. There's an item above me. So are we going to be actually going upwards in this segment? Not entirely sure. Let's go ahead and... I can't block that ducking. That's a little frustrating. Well, whatever. Oh, God. So many enemies. You got to take them down. Take them down now. Yeah. Never a good thing to jump into that many enemies. And I didn't kill the guy, you know, shooting projectiles, which should have been the first thing I did. Whatever. I did all that for 2 MP, which is kind of nice. This is a really mazy level. Fuck off, man. And I can't kill him with one dive attack, so you're like, it wants you to use magic on that, oh god, on that guy that I saw before on the single platform. I can't dive attack anyone in this level. Okay, let's calm down. My thoughts are just everywhere. The commentary is no doubt gone to just complete madness as I'm just trying to string together sentences incoherently. Let's wait for this platform. I don't think we're going to be going up anytime soon. In fact, we're probably going to be dying. So we're going to be going down very soon. Almost flapped my way off of the platform there. This is very nerve-wracking. I'm going to pray to God that there's some health over here and that I can get to it without dying to Stabby McGee. Stabby McGee actually did get his stab off. No, I fucking... God damn it. Alright, the only reason I'm coming back here is because it could possibly be a one-up. I doubt it because the game is basically giving me the middle finger this level. But, alright, yeah, that would have been tremendously helpful. But the best way to, you know, when you encounter a situation like that, yeah, it's a little frustrating. I could have really used that. But it's in the past. The only thing I can do now is just learn from it and don't let the game get to you. If the game gets to you, it wins. If we can get to the boss, we have so much magic. I guarantee you we can do this. So all we need to do is make it to the boss. Speak of the devil, please, dear God. Okay, this is not M, but that's okay. We got this guy flapping above me. I probably don't want to just fall downwards. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, actually, wasn't as bad as I originally thought. I definitely don't want anything to do with those Slimers, though. You gotta stop diving upwards, man. Come on, there we go. That's all I wanted to do that whole time. Alright, so we got guys throwing daggers literally through solid stone. Makes me a little nervous. This is so fucking mazy. Why did the last level of the day have to be so mazy? Alright, more of these laser Medusa heads. Good, good on you. It's, you know, the lasers suck ass. This is really bad. The lasers suck ass, but the worst thing about them is they just spawn on top of you all the time. That's just literally what they do. And there's really no forgiving that because you have literally nothing the player can do to respond in time. And ultimately, that the design is just terrible on that. I'm sorry. Okay, taking this blob guy down. I can't dive attack him in one hit. Maybe I should... Oh, my God. I was going to say, maybe I should just ignore him. I am so freaking lost, viewers. And this is my last life. When I, Ooh, please have a one-up or something. Alright, a little bit of health. It's not the best, but whatever. But yeah, I am so freaking lost. When I die, there's going to be no way I'm going to be able to get back here reliably. It's so confusing to me. Alright, let's head up here. And maybe this is the right way to go. This is kind of, you know, very close to where we started off in this level. Jesus Christ, this dagger guy. All these enemies can shoot through the ground. It makes me sad. Well, no, my magic can't go through the ground, can it? I don't know, maybe I have a spell that does. I can't think of any that do, though. So yeah, I'm totally wrapping back around to where I started off. Yeah, if I go up here... Yeah, I've definitely been here before. well, you can't go up these spikes. But I kind of would like to go up there. I don't think there are any hidden walls in this game. There may be, but... Just for my own sanity, I'm going to believe that there aren't. And I'm pretty much going back exactly to the very start of the area, which is not good. I cannot wait to die just so I can edit all this shit out and, you know, just get on with my life. Because I know what's going to happen. Oh, actually, this is an exit here? Oh God, it's not over yet. Why is it not over? Mommy, help! Alright, no choice but to go down here. Oh God, health, health, health. Magic is not what I needed, sadly. Oh, whoa. I've been here before. Yes, this is the area I was in last time. Oh no, Alan. Why did you boot up a maze for the last level of the video? Alright, well, there will be some heavy editing here. But for now, let's just... Oh, does that mean that 10 HP is back? I could definitely use that. Alright, so... We just gotta watch out here for all of these assholes in this room. There are a ton of them. Let's just go ahead and take down a few with magic. I just do not want to fuck around, I'm sorry. Okay. So we are back up to a little bit more HP. Do I want to go back to that previous area? It really confused the dog piss out of me. I don't exactly have any options, though, do I? Because we are heading up to that spike on the ceiling. Maybe I want to go in there. Oh, good God. Well, we're back into this main area with, you know... I don't even know how to describe it. With all these weird passages. Oh, God. And literally the exact same thing is happening that that happened last time. Just die. Die. Oh, my gentle Jesus. Get the fuck up there, master. And I've lost, like, almost all the health that I just gained. I can't fight all of these guys. It's either going to be dagger-throwing guy, the guy swooping at me, or all the jellies on the ground. There's a guy throwing daggers through the fucking ground. Alright, calm down now. There I go again. I started raging. I gotta not rage. Gotta keep a cool head and be very observant about the paths that I am taking here. However, I think my untimely demise is about to happen, which is unfortunate because I think I've kind of sussed out where I need to go. But now I gotta replay the entire level, so why don't we go ahead and just warp back there, shall we? God damn it, I knew those were there. Alright, here we are back here where I, you know, died that one time a few lives ago. I actually made it back here just a few moments ago, and then one of the Medusa heads just spawned on top of me, knocking me down like four floors, so yeah, that was a little frustrating. Okay. This is a really God, seriously, bro, you gotta stop, I know. That was a really harrowing jump, so that makes me think that we may actually be on the right track, on the right path here. I'm totally guessing, of course, but basically, typically in games, the more perilous, you know, you put yourself in, you know, the more perilous the situation you put yourself in, the better the reward, and I'm hoping the reward here is gonna be some fucking progress. How about that? Yes! Okay, is this... Oh, it's this guy again. Alright, recycling mini-bosses now, is that what we're doing? I don't know if I can do this. He's definitely vulnerable to slashes. If I just knock him back, or he sometimes shield blocks. I don't have enough health to tank this guy. I don't know what you want from me. Were they, like, worshipping him? I don't know. There's, like, a little statue here striking a pose. It's kind of funny. So, that is unfortunate. Video game! And there you go, buddy. Awesome. Fucking awesome. Great. Oh, I love that jump. Great. Oh my fucking god, what the hell? Hey guys, look where I am. Look how much health I have. Yeah, literally the only damage I've taken is from enemies just randomly spawning on top of me. Isn't it just wonderful, wonderful level design? Truly, it is masterful game design. I love it. Trying to make me cry, game. Oh god, he saved my life. He saved my life. Fuck off, all of you. I'm so sick of you spawning on top of me all the time. Okay. Pixel perfect jumps, the video game. The movie, the game. And here we are back at the mini boss. Alrighty. Can you tell? Can you hear the enthusiasm in my voice, viewers? Okay, so. Get like one. Now he's gonna counter. One, two, three. Just keep knocking him back. Just grind into him. You know, that's what the enemies in this game do. Why can't I do it to them? I'm pretty much just accepting my death here. Yep. Alrighty, here I am back here. I am gonna give this guy my fucking all. Magic really doesn't seem to be too effective on him. But I figure I can maybe get like some Phoenix slashes off. I don't think I'm gonna use my little lava balls on him at all. They just never seem to fucking hit. He almost got me there. That was actually kind of scary. Now, the Phoenix Strike really doesn't seem to do anything at all either. So it wants me to just spam physical on this guy, which I guess I can do. But when he can just grind into me, you know, as much as he pleases without taking any sort of damage or, you know, no ramifications at all, really doesn't seem like it's such a good idea to engage an enemy physically, does it? I don't know, it doesn't seem too fair, does it? Alright, there we go, we did a little bit of damage. If I can just take this guy down. The thing that is really just crushing my soul and making me not want to progress is the fact that this guy is just the mini-boss. He is just... no, I'm just gonna keep talking because I'm pretty fucking pissed. This level design, I've been playing this a really long time. It's just so poor. It's so unfair. And it's just not fun in the slightest. I've been trying to be very fair to this game, you know, give it a lot of chances. But this is just fucking misery incarnate. Maybe that's what they're going for. You know, we are in a prison. It's pretty miserable. But I don't know. It's just not fun. And as a player, a game needs to be fun. And that, yeah, pixel perfect jump. That has killed me so many times. I can't even talk. I'm getting so angry. Jump. Oh, I think I made it there. Yes. You have to be just spot on. It has to be the best pixel perfect jump you can make. And yeah, I've been doing this, just having fun with the glitchiness of this game. Just trying to humor myself, honestly, because it is so frustrating. I cannot believe that guy is still teleporting at me and trying to grind into me. Yeah, he's still... Look, yep, you're gonna get hit off? No, he almost did. Good God. Alright, mini-boss. Can I just skip you? No, I can't. Nice, very nice. That was a really good hit. I can't just jump through the trap door. I'm trying to do the, you know, physical hit thing, but the game really doesn't seem to want me to actually do that. I don't know what it wants from me here. It wants me to use... physical hits, but when I do, he's just grinding into me, and that's all he does. I don't know. I have no fucking idea what I just did. Alright, welcome back to Actraiser 2, viewers. I'm gonna edit out so many deaths, and I'm not even gonna put them in a death montage, because I have died so many times. Go. Okay, yeah, that's nice. Yeah, it's not even, it's to the point where it's not even funny anymore. The design is just so terrible. This is so punishing. What do you have against the player, Enix? Like, this is really, really bad. Alright, I don't even know what to do here. We'll just wait for these. We'll wait for these to go up, we'll land on that platform, then we'll wait on the upper platform for the bottom spikes. We'll kind of just rinse repeat here. Why do you hate the players so much? We're supporting your company. You're really gonna treat them like this? I don't know. It seems really poor taste. But yeah, there are probably like 11 billion deaths that you're not gonna see. And me just almost throwing the controller in so much rage. Really, really bad. We need to keep moving here. Is this gonna kill me? Joy! Joy to the world! The spikes have come. I am losing my mind. No, really, you think I'm joking? I'm literally losing my mind. I can't string together any sort of coherent sentence at all. I'm just so raging. And the whole time, like, every time I died, I would tell myself, this is the mini boss, and it made me that much more, you know, just full of rage. I am not even halfway done with the level yet, basically, is what I was thinking. It's just so punishing, and I just truly don't understand why you would design a game that is designed to just make the gamer, I don't know, hate himself, basically. It's just very poor. Like, I seriously was like, I want to just go play some Kaizo and relax a little bit. Like, I was just getting so mad. Oh man, it's the Goblin King. Alright, hey Goblin King, how's it going? I just threw a ball into your face. I'm really not interested in this fight at all, so I hope you die relatively easily. Because I don't want to do all this over again, and if I do have to, oh my god, I'm going to have to do this over again, aren't I? Alright, if we take down his barrier with our sword, and then throw the balls, be careful, he likes to shoot out giant spirit balls. Okay, here we go, take down his barrier. This is such shitty design, I cannot even begin to tell you. Here we go, yep, spirit ball. He can grind into me as well. And he instantly put up his barrier again. Wow, cool. Okay. There you go, nope, didn't take down the barrier. Maybe I should just keep spamming the balls, I don't know. Here we go, maybe lay on some damage here. Yeah, that was awesome. Okay, careful, watch for his Genki-Dama. And, yep, awesome, fuck you. Fuck your level. Pure ecstasy is what you're hearing right now. God damn it, that level sucked so bad. That really just kind of ruined the whole game for me. I'm not even going to lie about it. I hate to be, you know, the stereotypical raging gamer, but that's actually what that level did to me. It was just so bad. And, it, you know, it didn't help that I had to play through it about probably 30 times, maybe even more than that. Yeah, really, demons, I don't care about this fucking plot at all anymore, so if you want to read this, viewers, go ahead. I need a break. So, as always, thank you so much for watching. Sorry about the anger, and I'll see you next time. Yeah, see that metal word? Sure does look like shit, doesn't it? Yep. See you next time.